Okay, hi, I'm Kenneth Squires, and I'm going to show you how I start to pattern a horse. And just the fundamentals and the things I like to get down as a basic to starting a colt around the barrels. I have my points where I ride them to, and I want to teach them the same spot every time. I give them a little more room than I would if I was running them in the beginning. And then I move them in accordingly to what they need and the kind of horse they are as they get older. You can always move one in, but it's real hard to move them back out. Ooh. I'm gonna stop a horse way up here every time. It's gonna be 6 or 8 feet from the barrel. I want them to tip their nose. I want them to give me plenty of room. And around this backside, I want them to give me that nose real pretty. I bring them all the way up. Well, you can see where this cone is. I'm gonna bring my horse all the way around the first barrel every time before I go to the second barrel. He's gonna be directly in line with basically where I wanna go to my spot that's a little bit wider on a colt than it would be on a made horse to right here. If he doesn't come all the way around that barrel and be straight, that is me setting that horse up to always have a real complete turn, and it sets you up for the second barrel. Your first barrel makes your second barrel, is in my opinion, especially on a colt. It sets them up to come all the way around the turn and not break and run too soon and get themselves in a bind getting over to the second barrel. I'm gonna have, usually a horse will have, this horse doesn't really need it, but I want that hip a little to the inside of the shoulder. And they're gonna sit here. My leg is gonna be a little bit further back than the barrel. It's not gonna be right beside the barrel when I stop one, unless the horse is really, really tight. But this is my point for a Scotchy horse. I'm gonna move them all the way up into this hole so they know not to shut down back there. And a horse that needs to set, I want him to know, I want his butt in the ground by the time I get right here. And I tip their noses, and then I bring them. And you'll notice it's slow, it's methodical. If I'm thinking like I should be, see how her shoulders stayed straight, and that nose came right with that barrel. That means my horse's body doesn't move when their noses move. That takes a lot of time and piddling. and it doesn't come easy for me, but I want the body to stay straight and the head to give. And if I can do that, that colt is already set up to know how I want him to run. All this time, there's not a whole lot of bending around with my body. I want me straight. I want their heads straight until I get up here. I don't mind them bending a little bit so I know I got their handling right. But when I stop one, whoo. When my butt hits that saddle, my horse better be thinking about setting or I'm not happy. And if they'll come around the barrel like that easy, it won't be long. And I really like to have some patience with a colt. When you start going a little faster, and you'll know when it's time to go faster. If you don't want to... You don't want to go backwards. You don't want to fluster them by pushing them too hard or get a horse too latent with going slow. They need to pick up their feet and handle, and they need to come around the barrel easy and really be patterned. It may take 6 months, it may take 2 years, depending on the speed you go, but keep your horse moving forward every day and prepare them to go a little faster and do a little better. I think as long as you keep your colts handling, don't even get on them and start them around the pattern unless they're tired. Then they're picking their feet up and they're stopping and they're paying attention to you. It's not worth doing if you hadn't got their head in the game. And if you're just going around the barrels not thinking about it, make no mistake, one of you is thinking about it. If you're not thinking about where you're going, that colt is. So mean everything you show them. It really does matter. And I can't express enough that when you go make a pass on your colt or your older horse at a faster speed, go back and follow your tracks and see if you went exactly where you wanted to go. And then go slow work them accordingly. If you need to pick something up, bear it in mind the next go. Don't keep doing the same thing wrong, because same thing wrong takes a long time to take out of one.